Hello and welcome. Today I'm looking at the HTC Desire. It became apparent after recording this video that I had the gimbal set to 720p. So hopefully the quality is enough to get across the message, and apologies. This is just a demo to test out the sound, camera, lighting. So please bear with this. I'm just giving this a go. There's a few mistakes, a few errors. I might dub over them. If you see some blurring on the video, it's because you could see my stupid face in the reflection. So I have tried to edit that out. Cheers. Hello and welcome. Today, I'm looking at an old phone. The HTC Desire. There's a few models of the Desire. This is, I think, maybe the first version. Just straightforward HTC Desire. This is a rebought phone. So I used to have this, I got rid of it, and I've recently acquired another device. Let's give it a quick wipe over and a clean, and we'll see if this can still run websites, YouTube, any other apps that it has. So let's switch this on. It should have a small amount of charge. Let's see what the boot time is for something this old. There it goes, struggling through its own boot logo. Don't remember that being a very famous strap line. Quietly brilliant. So I have already turned this on. It's got a connection to my home Wi-Fi. And it's trying to boot here. Asking me to set my current time. No SIM card installed. I didn't want to worry about getting hold of an extra SIM, getting a new number for this, or topping it up with a few pounds worth of credit for demonstration. Let's see what it can do just on Wi-Fi. So it seems to be stuck on this non-menu screen here. It's just like, let's give home a hard press there. No recent apps. Let's give that a decent click there. So it's either that these keys are particularly bad on my purchased device, or it has frozen without being able to load up anything. Ah, here we go. So let's just do a fast, whoops. Ah, it's okay. So this wants to search apps then through this Google search, not, this isn't, is this, oh yeah, okay. It will search websites. Let's test what sort of speed. No speed at all. So this is running Android 2.2.2, and since I think September of this year, a lot of websites have had their certificates updated, which means that this operating system and browser can no longer connect to many websites. It will connect to Google. I'm guessing they've still got a version that runs non-secure, so it's not checking any certificates. But as soon as I try and go to a website that is secure, it seems to fail in its connection. So I'm limited to non-secure websites. Let's go past, let's see if speed test, see, security warning. This phone can't understand the most recent certificates. It thinks that it's not trusted. It very likely is from speed test. Let's just force that to continue and you get a very limited experience. It's likely that speed test use many content delivery networks to download their assets to you. This is not working well, is it at all? So the HTC Desire, it was okay at the time. It was a low to mid budget mobile. Let's see. Camera. I think it's probably a couple of megapixel camera. What is it asking me to just press the middle one to take a picture? Is that the button on this? It's not even showing me in the camera roll there. Okay, so it has no onboard memory on which to save photos, so that is a non-starter. I do have one, maybe I'll put one in and see what sort of quality those pictures are later. As for built-in apps, we've got its own version of Facebook, Google Mail, which has probably been renamed to something else by now, maybe, I'm not sure about that. So it also won't let me connect to there. Oh, it might actually, it might do. Oh, I've got to have my Google account, I won't do that on camera either. Maybe I'll make a burner email for that. It's got Peep, which I'm assuming is some sort of Twitter client, which doesn't want to load. Again, that might be a certificate issue. Let's go to, it's got Quick Office, Stocks, Tita, I think is a game. Let's see what graphical capabilities this has got. Oh, you might not be able to see that. It's a ball tilt thing. Don't get it in the holes. Get that down like that. Let's quit from that. And let's see if I can get anything on YouTube through this. There was a problem starting up. Please check network connections and check that the system time is set correctly. The time is approximately right. It's only 30 seconds out, if that. I think it's probably to do with the network and the certificate. Look, it won't load any real content. It's just loading the placeholder content there. I go to most viewed, view all of most viewed, and there's a problem. So that this phone is probably only going to be useful for sending messages, and that is if I put a SIM card in it. I haven't added any contacts or proper settings to this yet, apart from my Wi-Fi. So this is what, 10 years old or so now, about 10 years old, this phone. So I had this when it was first released. It's a good pocket sized phone at the time. I put this on the on here. We've got a width of probably 50 millimeters and a length of 130 millimeters there. Thickness wise, it's probably, let's line that up on there, 12 or 13 millimeters. I get that at a diagonal to the camera. Is a fairly nice phone in your palm. If only it had a slightly faster chip and could be updated to run on more modern websites. I could use it as a, maybe a Spotify remote. I could use this as, not much, an email second, just have my emails on it on a second screen. I might still be able to do that if it will allow me to connect to Gmail. I'll test that out at some point. I'll do a deeper dive if there's any success on that. If there's no success, I won't bother posting that. But thanks for listening. This is the HTC Desire. I am Stuff on Shelves, and remember, don't sit so close to the internet. Thanks a lot.